What is up, guys? Alpine Gremlin again here with some more World of Tanks. Today we're going to be taking a look at the VK3002D. This is the Tier 7 German medium tank. Well, one of the two Tier 7 German medium tanks. The other one being the Panther, which leads to the E50M. And the VK leads to the Leopard 1. And the reason why I'm grinding this tank all of a sudden is because I really want a Leopard 1. I tried it on the test server and it was a lot of fun. I had just as much fun, if not more fun, driving the Leopard as I did the T-62A and the 140. So definitely a tank I want to get. Now you can see that this tank looks very similar to hull-wise to a T-34. And that's because the Germans developed this in response to the T-34. It was one of their designs. You could see that they actually look pretty similar. The VK is pretty decently armored for a Tier 7 medium tank, especially when compared to things like the T-20 and the T-43. You could see that it's got 80 millimeters of frontal hull armor here on the front slope, and that front slope is pretty well angled. It's comparable, actually, to the Foch's angling. You could see, obviously, there's a difference in thickness, but it's still pretty effective armor for a Tier 7. And if you angle it a little bit to the left or right when in an engagement, you will find that you can bounce some shots that go to your lower plate. Your upper front plate, I mean. Your lower plate is actually much weaker. It's flat. People are going to penetrate every time if they shoot there. The turret is 120 millimeters thick, but it's very flat, so most guns from like heavies and TDs will be able to penetrate that. Your cupola can be shot out, and I've noticed that it isn't too effective of a side scraper because of these. They're either exhaust or in-tank vents. I'm not sure, because the exhaust is here. Anyway, it has something to do with that function. And so when you're side scraping, I have noticed that I've been penetrated here, so I think this is a hitbox zone, though I'm not entirely sure. That could just be a mistake, that I took damage. I happened to take a shot there at the same time I took damage. But anyway, from what I've seen, side scraping is not the best option in this. However, it is a medium tank. It goes 56 kilometers per hour. It's a little bit slow getting up to speed. And it's odd because you would think that a tank with such, it's got a decent power to weight ratio, 720 horsepower, and it only weighs about 40 tons. So that's not a bad power to weight ratio, but it feels like it gets up to speed a little bit sluggish at first. But once it's in a straight line and going forward, it can move. Its traverse speed is relatively slow, only 42 degrees per second. Compare that to something like the T-62A, which has around 56 degrees per second of traverse. It can be a little bit difficult to turn in this machine. And overall, in my opinion, at Tier 7, this is a very strong tank when it's top of the list. You can see it has a 1,250 hit point pool, which means that it has some very, very good hit points for a Tier 7 medium. It's comparable to equivalent-teir heavy tanks. The T-29 has the exact same amount of hit points, for example, 1,250. So you have some HP to throw around when you're top tier. The problem with this tank, though, is that it finds itself in high-tier matches. And in high-tier matches, it's not that effective, in my opinion. And why is that? Well, it's the mediocre selection of guns. You can see on the VK3002D that there are only a choice of four guns to use. And in my opinion, only two of the four are viable for most players. The 7.5cm KWK40L48 is what you get stock on this. It's the stock gun on the VK3001D. And it's the best gun on the Panzer 3-4. So, best gun on a Tier 5 medium tank. This gun, don't even worry about it. It's mediocre. It is not competitive at this tier at all to be mounted on a Tier 7 medium. The 7.5cm KWK42L70 is a decent choice, as well as the only other viable option being the 8.8cm KWK36L56. And we're going to take a look at these two guns here in a second. The 105, well, here, we'll go over these. So we won't even worry about the first 75. You shouldn't even be having that if you ground out all the XP on the 3001D. You should already have this gun. So this is what you should be starting with in your first battle. The other option, after researching it, is the KWK 8.8 centimeter L56. So we'll take a look at these two guns. We'll also bring up the 105 Derp just because, why not? Oh, I don't even have it researched, so we'll look at that in a second. So you could see these two guns. In my opinion, I use the 7.5 centimeter. Why? Because it has the best penetration and the best rate of fire, which means it has the best DPM. The 88 does 220 damage per shot, but you only have 132 millimeters of penetration, and you only get 9.38 rounds per minute. It's also 0.38 accuracy, which is not very accurate for a German gun. They both have the same aim time of 2.3 seconds, but I like the 7.5 over the 88 because of the increased penetration, 150 as opposed to 132, 194 with premium ammo as opposed to 171. The average damage is only 135, which is not very strong at this tier. The 8.8 does have the advantage in terms of alpha. However, you could be putting out a lot more shots in the 7.5 centimeter than you can on the 88. And this is where this tank encounters problems. Now, the 105 millimeter derp gun it's really only effective if you fire premium rounds with it, and even then, it only has 104 millimeters of pen. Yes, it does 350 average damage, but honestly, if you look at the aim time, it doesn't even say here, but the rate of fire is slow. The aim time is slow because it's a derp gun, and it just isn't that reliable of a penetration for penetration. So I much prefer to use the 7.5 centimeter. However, this low alpha damage means that it's very hard to carry games in this tank, and especially in games where you are bottom tier, tier 9, which you will see at least one of these games in this video, it is near impossible to carry in this tank. It's not impossible, but it's near impossible because of the low alpha output of the gun. I really do not like, and I do load premium rounds. This is one of the few tanks that I do actually use premium ammo in. Now, this tank is a little bit of a brawler because of its good armor, but you don't really want to be brawling with anything higher than you because your armor quickly becomes ineffective. And honestly, I don't think that this tank really has any place being at top tier, being, you know, anywhere and other than tier 8, because it falls so short. The gun falls so short, and the armor becomes quickly outclassed. And that's why I haven't really been having the best time in this thing. You just can't carry. It's very difficult. If we look at my stats in it, for example, it's down here somewhere. I've got a 30% win rate in this, but I only have 712. I have 712 average experience. I wish I got that on some when I win games sometimes. It's nuts how it's pretty crazy just how if ineffective this is at carrying. It just doesn't have the alpha to put higher tier vehicles down. And that's the biggest problem with this tank, is the mediocre selection of guns. And you're going to find that is its biggest handicap. Yeah, if you want alpha, you can go for the 88, but you're going to have a hell of a time penetrating targets, and it's not as accurate. So I prefer the 75mm. You guys probably disagree with me, and I'd love to hear your opinions on this, on what you would recommend on the gun as the gun choice. But for me, the best viable choice is the 7.5cm, even though it doesn't do a whole lot of damage per shot. Let's take a look at crew skills. Everybody's training in repairs. Obviously, because it is more of a brawling type of medium, I want my modules back up ASAP. In terms of my equipment, I only have two equipment pieces fitted, a rammer just to get that DPM up even more, and improve vents to, again, help with the reload and general crew. In terms of my ammo loadout, 35 rounds of AP. I actually, again, this is one of the few tanks that I do actually pack premium ammo in just because of the poor penetration. I carry 25 APCR and 20 high explosive rounds for emergency resets. Small repair kit, small first aid kit, automatic fire extinguisher. So anyway, guys, that's the tank in the garage. Let's take it out, show a few battles in different situations, and see how it performs. All right, so this is the VK as top tier. So it's a tier 7 battle. We're on Lakeville, starting from the south during an encounter battle. Now, obviously, a lot of people on this map going valley really is not a viable option. You could send a few people there, but if you send most of your people to the valley, your guys in the town are just going to get overrun and you're going to get capped out, because the valley really restricts your tank's ability to move. So what you're going to want to do is you really want to send the majority of your people to the town to have the best fighting chance. This is less so on standard battle, but the town is still remains the, you know, a point of importance. Additionally, luckily we have a Panzer IV and an ELC going to spot the mid, because the mid is map control, considering the middle can fire into the town. So you want the town and you want to have the middle map control area. Now I'm going, you can see right here, one of the other disadvantages of the VK is the slow turret traverse. So that means that in order to really keep up with tanks flanking you, you have to turn your whole tank, which it decreases the accuracy of the gun. Luckily, though, it's not too inaccurate to the point where you can't acquire targets quickly. It does have a relatively quick aiming time. So we're waiting. You see an enemy's on the cap. The VK 3002M is just going to donkey in there, I guess. So I'm going to stay back and put a nice shot into that M2A5 Stuart. VK wastes him. We got some targets up in mid, but I have no shots on him right now, and that SU-85 is going to go down anyway, so I decide, whatever, I'll just help here. But I notice, oh, shit, SU-152, and he penetrates me in the frontal armor. Now, he's using the D-25T, so he hits me with a D-25T, so that easily goes through my armor. Now, I'm going to... you could see, though, that I was able to penetrate his frontal armor. So the 75 is, again, competitive at this tier. I was able to easily go through the guy's frontal armor. And, you know, it was overall a good engagement for me. I did take one hit, though. So here, shooting into the side of this M6, I shoot his upper front plate, though, and I bounce. So I start shooting at the KV-1. But it just goes wide and hits the building. That goes through. But now he starts moving and he starts giving me the weird angles and I bounce. Not that shot, though. That shot tracks him. Now we're just going to melt him thanks to the great DPM, but still low alpha damage of this gun, you could see. And I bounce, but the IS on our team takes him out. So now I'm going to melt this M7, who, as you can see, that was the only shot he actually penetrated on me. He was only able to penetrate that one shot. So I'm going to melt this M6 down a little bit. IS takes him out. Now we're moving on to the T-29. My shot goes low. I play kind of bad here in terms of my shots. I don't really place them that well, especially the T-29 is a pretty well-armored target as a tier 8 at tier 7. So I put one into the back of his turret. Now he's moving back towards me, so I'm going to put one into his upper front plate because I can penetrate that. I angle, and you can see he bounces. I believe he bounced off of, you can see where he ricocheted off the side of my turret there. So angling this tank does prove to have some troll bounces once in a while. There's a T-43. I bounce off him. He misses me, and he was face-hugging me. I was face-hugging him. I made a mistake of doing that with a Soviet heavy, and I just ended up bouncing. But now that I've gained some distance, I can penetrate his lower hull, and we take him out. Now, there's really only... The scores are
we're actually losing at this point because everybody really went to the town. So what we're going to do is I'm going to finish off this ARL, or rather, you can see I angled myself a little bit, and he aimed in the wrong spot as I angled it, and he bounced. And the IS and the T-20 takes him out. Now, that was bad play by me. In all honesty, I really should have gone around and gotten up close to him and flanked him. Instead, I just tried to have a, you know, kind of like a sniper a duel with that TD. That was not the best option for me. Luckily, he wasn't all that great, and I was able to troll him with my armor, and my team came and helped me out. He wouldn't have killed me. I would have melted him down pretty fast, but he would have done a lot more damage to me, and I would have been in a more precarious position. I take a shot at the SU, but I miss. So now we're just contesting the cap so that they, you know, we're not under that pressure. There are three non-RDs left. The M7 back there, the SU-152, and the IS. Now, I see the IS aiming at me because I noticed, so I move behind the cover of the KV-1 wreck. The M41 just took out our Black Prince, though, so now it is 2-on-3. I'm going to go... I think about going to take this M7 on, but I realize that he is long gone, so I'm going to help the IS take on this SU-152 just to get him out of the fight, because he does have a 122mm. Unfortunately, server lag forces me to miss my shot. I do penetrate that shot, though. I bounce, and the IS takes him out. I probably could have landed more shots with that, but that was some... It wasn't really the best play on my part. So now the IS is on the cap. He's looking for his top gun, actually. He's got 5 kills. The IS did a good job. So hats off to him. He played his role well as a top-tier heavy tank. So now the M7 is trying to come and brawl with me. He did penetrate that shot because he caught me side-on. However, now I am able to angle my armor against him. He is not able to penetrate any of his shots. Notice I'm actually down. I actually used up all of my standard rounds on that during that game. I'm now down to my premium rounds, which I actually haven't used any this round, and my HE, which I also haven't used. So as you can see, at tier 7, this 75mm is a viable option. Even in front-on engagements, because, you know, most of the targets don't have that much armor yet. Artie's up. So I'm just going to melt him. Move a little bit so he can't get me head-on and fire. Get the kill for the win. Alright, so there's that battle. It wasn't the greatest battle ever. I feel like I made some bad play. I made a few bad plays, and I probably could have done a lot more damage than I actually did if I hadn't have made those mistakes. Or I haven't, you know, donked so many shots. But it is what it is. We won. And I ended up getting a decent amount of XP out of it. So let's take out the post-game stats. Alright, so here's the after-action report for that battle. You can see that we did the most damage on our team. 2,880 damage in this Tier 7 game. We got 2 kills for 1,162 experience. We also got 3 Battle Hero Award medals. High Caliber, Confederate, and Steel Wall. With 37 shots fired, 30 direct hits, and 24 penetrations. I was really just spamming... I was really spamming the fire in that game. You know, not all my shots were very well placed. However, you notice I did take a potential damage of 2,165 damage. That's almost pretty much double. That's almost double my HP, and that's just that troll thick armor at tier 7. You know, especially on a medium tank, it is. You know, other lower tiers are not going to really be able to penetrate you. Really, only tanks your tier are going to be able to do that reliably, especially if you angle it like that M7 found out, and a couple other tanks too. T29 got a troll bounce and stuff like that. So that is the VK with a good team, with a team that was supportive, and in a tier 7 game. So now we're going to take a look at something a little bit different. We're going to take a look at the VK. In a very, very unfriendly environment with a team that really isn't that great. All right, so here we are. We can see that we are in a very, very unfriendly environment to the VK 3002D. We're in a tier 9 game on mines with artillery in play. So this is going to be difficult to pull off. You could see that they really don't have anything on their team that's really quick enough to beat me to the hill. So my plan is to get to the hill and play from there. I platooned up with a buddy of mine, Murdoch. He's in his SU-122-44. And we're going to see what we can't do in this Tier 9 game. Now, spoiler alert, this is a loss. And this is a perfect example of why the VK really doesn't have a... in my opinion, does not have a place in Tier 9. In Tier 9 games. It's just, if your team is bad, you really can't carry. The alpha's just too low. It can't put people down. And you're going to see what happens in this game. There are multiple reasons why. I can't just blame the gun for the loss here, but it is a factor. The very unimpressive alpha is one of the reasons. Now, it isn't the only reason, but it is a reason. And I will point out several of the errors made here that do not allow me to fully win, that don't allow me to pull this off. However, you can see that Artie just splashed. I'm coming over here for some early spots on what's coming to this town. You could see an IS and a an IS-3 and a T-29 at the very least. Artie, I do have to move though because Artie is splashing the hill near the Lorraine in particular. So I am going to want to keep on the move and keep moving in unpredictable patterns. Now you can see right off the bat, I load my premium APCR rounds. I know that's what I'm going to have to do here if I want to do anything. So I move down over up the hill here. I do get spotted because proximity. However, I do get some free shy shots on this AT-15. There's another shot. I only get two shots on him though because the M103, again, I tunnel vision, didn't see him coming. And he destroyed my turret ring and took 427 of my HP away. Now, since the turret already turns so slow, I had to repair that. Otherwise, this tank would basically have no turret, almost. So I help my team melt this T-54E1 down. There's one of their tier 9s out of action. Now I'm going to start putting more ammo into the side of the M103. Now, yes, I am using premium ammo here. I know I don't usually do that, but in this game with this tank, I really, really need to use premium ammo. The penetration of this 75 just isn't enough to be taking on these heavies like that. It's possible that I bounce that M103 side if I wasn't using standard rounds. So that M103 is just fixated on me right now, even though there's a Yag Tiger right over there. So I'm going to wait to lose the spot a little bit, and I'm going to see if I can't get a better approach right now. But I notice, wait a minute, the M103 is not looking my way. Now's my chance to melt him while the weak side of his turret is pointing the other direction. I actually can penetrate him with non-standard ammo, but I don't want to waste the time to reload, so I'm just going to go up there and I'm going to start taking shots at the side of his turret. And you can see the good rate of fire lets me do it relatively quickly. Now I get two shots in him. Don't want to push it though, because he is looking my way again. However, I notice that he starts turning his attention away from me again, and I get the kill. So there's a top tier heavy eliminated. Now I'm down to 13 premium ammo rounds. I haven't really fired anything else. Now, this is an important thing. I'm sure many of you are aware of the 50-meter spotting range, and this mod here does help me see where my spotting range is, so I know, when I'm in range to get spotted, in addition to my sixth sense going off. Now, I want to take shots on this T-30 here. However, I can see that this IS is within proximity range of spotting me, so I know that I've been spotted. And if I were to go out and take a shot at the T-30, I would just die or get severely damaged by people that are, looking this way. So I opt not to go out and take those shots, but instead I'm going to go and help the flank near the town because the T-30 on our team is alone. However,
before that, you could see I get out of proximity range of the IS, and I wait for the arties to fire. You can see they both fire there. I'm not spotted anymore, so I'm gonna take a couple cheeky shots at this T-30's lower plate. And I back off because I don't want to get hit by that 155mm gun he's using. So I back off the hill again, and I decide to go help the town. However, there really aren't any good shots for me over here, as you're going to see. I spend too much time aiming on this Yag Panther 2, and I don't take the shots. Well, I take that shot, but it goes low because I didn't spend the time to aim. Now, I'm burning premium rounds here. I've only got 10 left, so I switch back to regular armor piercing for the time being, because I know that I can penetrate this Yag Panther 2 if I manage to catch his side with standard ammo. Now, you notice what I'm doing on this hill. I'm not going back to the same flank two times in a row. I'm trying to stay unpredictable because I know that the arty is on me. They've already put a couple rounds on the hill. So I'm trying to mix, so I'm trying to change up the flanks that I'm going here to keep myself unpredictable so that they won't be able to guess where I'm going to pop up. Now that I realize I can't do much on that flank in the town, so I decide to head back and try and take more shots on the T-30. However, you could see that the IS proxy spotted. We proximity spotted each other again. So I opt out, once again, not to poke out and take shots at that T-30 just yet, because I don't know what has shots on me. And that, it's very possible that AC-15 could get into a position to do it. So I decide now to switch flanks again, and I'm going to help support this side of the hill. Now I see a KV fortress down there, and I reload my premium ammo because I know I'm going to have a hell of a time penetrating even his side armor. KV fortresses are very hard to pen for lower tier vehicles. So I'm putting shots into the side of his turret. He gets tracked by our JT, and I take him out for the kill. So I switch back to my regular rounds because I know I can penetrate this Yag Panther 2. Or Yag Panther Spy, whatever you want to call it. So now I'm in proxy range. I want to lose the proximity spot, and I'm going to change flanks again because, I don't want to be predictable. I don't want the arty to catch a beat on me. So I decide I'm going to go take more shots at this T-30 again because the IS has likely moved on. Okay, so right here is where I make a very, very crucial error. You can see that artillery over there. I'm covered from... I can hit that arty and kill him with about three shots while still being covered from the T-30 and the AT-15. Now, when I'm looking on my map, I figure that, oh, he's just behind the building. But this is a critical error on my part, and you're going to see why later. Because I should have taken out this artillery here. I should have melted it, but I didn't. And so it's going to end up biting me in the ass, and you'll see why later. I instead opt out to help this Yag Tiger with the 704, so I load more premium rounds, but you're going to see that this was a waste of effort. The 704 does have some pretty troll side armor because of the angling, so even my premium rounds are having trouble going in. They're getting eaten by the tracks, and they're bouncing off that angled armor. So I'm getting kind of frustrated here. I'm burning a lot of credits, with these shots. So I load. I just say screw it, and I switch back to regular armor piercing. I'm down to 3 of my 25 premium rounds, so they're really. I'm really getting low on what to do here. I'm running low on my premium ammo. So I decide to go take some shots on that Yag Panther Spy, but the Yag Tiger takes him out anyway. I see the 704 coming back up, possibly trying to get a beat on the Yag Tiger, so I move in to get ready to assist if needed, but the 704 backs off again at the sight of the Yag Tiger. So now I'm going to decide to go and take some more shots, to get some more cheeky shots on that T-30. So I'm going to go back to my bush here. I'm going to spot him, make sure he's within spotting view range. He is. There he is in the same spot I left him last time. And I put two shots into him. And you can see I take that last shot and back off immediately because I don't want to get hit by that gun.
You can see Artie, if you hear, Artie just splashed me. So now I'm going to change flanks again, keeping myself unpredictable. Now, I noticed that the IS just killed our JT that was in the middle, so I know he's got to be in a position. He's not spotted, so I know he's got to be in a position to hit him. So he's got to be somewhere around here, probably approaching our base to try and initiate a cap. You can see the 704 is here, the T-30 is here, and if you remember, the artillery is here. So I'm moving to these bushes here to see if I can get a stealth spot on the IS. I don't, so I move to the other set of bushes over here on this side of the rock to try and get a better picture. Now, you can see as I move, the IS just pops up. Now, I don't have sixth sense on this tank, so I don't actually know if I'm spotted yet. However, I do know I have to be spotted now because I am opening fire on him. So I do get one hit into the IS, but the other ones bounce. My standard rounds bounce. Now the IS is now in a, relative to my position, I really can't do much to him. Either it's going to bounce off of his turret, or it's just going to hit the house, which you see it does. Okay, now I'm alone. The Indian Panzer and the Tiger 1 that were over here dueling with the T-30 are dead. Artillery and the 704 took them out. So I'm alone against an artillery, an IS, and a 704. So not looking very good now. I see that this 704 is moving around here. He's probably going to get into a position to cover the IS because he probably figures that I'm going to rush straight across the field to try and stop the cap. So my plan was to load premium ammo. This is what's going through my head right now. I'm going to load the premium ammo. My plan is to come down on this side. With my premium rounds loaded, I'm going to come around behind the Object 704 and I'm going to hit him in the side while the IS is capping. Then once the 704 is down, I'm going to go and try and kill the IS, and then I'm going to come back and try and go for the Artie. So you can see in my UI, I'm loading my premium rounds, getting ready to flank the 704. Unfortunately, the artillery that I did not kill earlier is coming down to support them. And I don't want to waste my premium rounds on this guy, so I make the decision to switch back to regular armor piercing. And by that time, you could see he spotted me. And I have to waste time. I have to waste time killing him. And obviously, he fired at me. I've obviously been spotted. I kill the artillery, but now the 704 knows I'm here. My plan to get around his flank has probably failed, and if I went down there, that would mean that I would, if I went down there, then I'm probably going to meet him head on. Anyway, so I instead decide that I'm just going to go straight for the cap. I want to go straight for the cap because the 704 thinks I'm probably still going to be on the hill. So, however, I kind of confuse myself here because I think, you know, at one point I thought he was coming this way, so I decided, you know, he was going to be coming back this way. But then I decided that, hey, he could still be going that way. So I opt to go here along this route, you can see, and try and get to the cap there to take the IS by surprise without exposing myself to where I think the 704 is here. Unfortunately, the 704 saw me on the hill, as you remember when I had to kill that Artie. And he is on the hill. He went up to try and get me out. And so now, I load my premium rounds. I try to penetrate his side armor. I miss. It's too late. He whacks me. He whacks me there. I get my tracks back up. But you can see the, you know, this, and this is where one of the weaknesses of this tank comes in, the poor traverse speed. You can see I can't quite get my tank out of the way in time because of the traverse speed, and it takes me out. And you can see I just wasn't able to carry that game. And, you know, I made a couple crucial errors that probably could have changed the outcome of the game, but overall, this tank is just, it's very difficult to carry these high tier games in this tank, and that probably a game like this, you know, these are the kinds of games I can get and it explains why my average experience is relatively high for a tier 7 in this thing, but I've only got a 30% win rate because it just can't carry. So anyway, I know that was kind of depressing to watch. Let's take a look at the post-game stats.